I arrived in Qingdao City, which is here in Shandong Province.
Here you can see a small self-drawn map of Qingdao. So Qingdao is a coastal city in the east of China. And now I'm staying here in my hostel. And as you can see, here is something like a church. Jidutu Jiaotuang. And why are there so many churches? Because Qingdao once used to be a German colony. And used to be a German colony from the end, from 1897 until 1914. So it's like 16 or 17 years. So sometimes it's written like from 1898 until 1914. And then with the beginning of the First World War, the Japanese came into and took probably more or less over Qingdao City, and it says Diizi, so the first time the Japanese took over Qingdao until 1920. And then Beihang Zhengfu, then I think the Kuomintang took over the, well, I'm not sure, Min Guo Diizi. No, this is Kuomintang, 1923 to 1929, and then the Min Guo, this is like the China like it is today, Diizi 1929-1938, and Ruidian Diizi is 1938-1945 with the Japanese invasion, then they took over Qingdao. Yes, let's go and see what the city looks like. Oh, nice. Re Liu Huan Ying, like, yeah, warm welcome. Such a beautiful hostel. I'm about to buy my breakfast, and because most stores here in China are still closed, in Qingdao City is the same, so I'll buy an apple and not to forget the good Baozi. And you got like plenty of different choices and super cheap, so like something like three quires, like 40 euro cents, and they are pretty delicious, so I will get maybe three of them and then I'm good to go for first and can get further snacks later. So I'm gonna snack my Baozi when I'm going to explore the city of Qingdao. So while I'm walking around here, I found the license plate, which I want to explain to you again. And this is like Lu B. In China, the first character always signifies the province. And here in this case, Lu, this here, which is basically a fish over the sun, means, stands for Shandong province. Lu also means stupid. Sorry, I don't know why. But yeah, and the second letter B stands for the second biggest city of Shandong province. So Qingdao is not the capital province. The capital province of Shandong is Jinan. Jinan is like even bigger, but I think Jinan is way less touristy than Qingdao. So this is a church built by the Germans during the 1898 until 1914. In these 16 years, they built quite a lot though. And I'm just chilling here at this empty square. Usually here, I hear that here many people always taking wedding pictures, just as at beaches. And now, it's just me and these two girls over there chatting. So this church is a Tianzhu Jiaotang. So Tianzhu is basically Catholic Christianity, and Jiaotang is a church. And in Chinese, there's basically no real saying which says evangelic. So there's only Tianzhu, which means Catholic, and Jidutu, which means Christian, but nothing expressing specifically evangelic, like what I think. And here you have
Qingdao, Deguo, Jianzhu, Chun, Tianzhu Jiaotang. So Qingdao is the city here. Deguo is Germany. So this one here is a nation. De means basically like good. And Jianzhu is construction or architecture. Chun is group. So it's Qingdao German Architecture Group. Yeah, again the Catholic Church. And Zhonghua Renmin Gonghe Guo, Guo Fu Wu, 2006年5月25号日公示。So this long word here means the People's Republic of China. And Qingdao Shi Renmin Zhengfu Li, so from the city of Qingdao. Let's go, buddy. Another interesting thing I spotted here in Qingdao is this road. It says Qufu Lu, and Qufu is another town here in Qingdao, and it's a very important town because it's the birthplace of Confucius. So I arrived at the seafront at Qingdao, and it's super nice. This here is a really beautiful part of the Qingdao city. I really like this mixture of old Western architecture and like Chinese culture things, like this Fu over there, and looks really pretty. Like vintage kind of style. And here's a coffee. Let's get Meishi coffee. Meishi coffee is basically Americano, white idea. So it means like outside bringing prices. Because most coffees now, they don't let you sit inside, so you need to take it away. So let's buy one, I think. Yeah. 我想买，可以买吗？可以点一杯咖啡，美式咖啡，
没事。
美式，可以吗？
OK，OK，okay, okay.
一杯，
你好，
好的，好
外带
的，
吗？
呀，我的，我也不可以，在这里做不能吗？因为我也打算带我的电脑，做一些工作，不行啊，OK，这个咖啡店真的很漂亮
，Thank you。
Yeah, it's nice. So, got my Meishi coffee, my Americano coffee. And I know it's not environmentally friendly, but mei banfa, I don't have any other way. If you like to drink coffee, that's what you have to do. And Qingdao is like really a quite hipster city with a lot of, like hipster stores, hipster hostels, coffee shops. It's nice. Nice town, sea town here, Qingdao City. So, Qingdao so far is really a beautiful town with nice shops, nice architecture, beautiful landscape at the beach. And Qingdao is also famous for its beer, for the Qingdao beer, which is coming from a German brewery back during the German colonization time. So, basically, Qingdao is famous for its seafood because it's so close to the sea, for the beer, and I think for the old landscape here, and I would say for the kind of hipster art flair. So, I will go back to my hostel to eat this first vlog, and then, guys, stay tuned for more episodes from Qingdao, I hope.